I thought maybe many of you would want me to make this type of video. I had been thinking about doing this for over a year now, and the time has finally come. So without further ado, I will start talking about my entire life thus far. There may or may not be more than one part for this video. Alright, let's get started. I was born on November 4th, 1999, in Kealakekua, Hawaii. I don't remember much about what happened before 2005, so I will try to explain as best as I can. My father joined the Air Force in December 1999. I don't even remember the new millennium celebration because I was with my mother at some hotel, and we were unable to see it. I stayed in Hawaii for nearly 2 months before we traveled to Australia and stayed for about a year. In the summer of 2000, we moved to Tucson, Arizona. That was where my family met this other family, the Parker family. When I was 18 months old, I learned to draw letters for the first time, and I even drew the entire alphabet at the time. I was pretty smart for my age, I even counted to 100 before I was 6 years old. So anyway, I was almost 2 years old when the 9/11 attacks occurred, but I don't remember that at all. I didn't even expect people to make such a big deal about it, and even commemorate a holiday on September 11th. Just a few days after the attacks in 2001, my family moved to Germany, where we stayed in Otterburg for a while. Then we moved to Wartenberg-Rohrbach, near Sembach, where we stayed for 4.5 years. During our time in Germany, we went on holiday in several countries, such as France, Spain, Belgium, Luxembourg, the Netherlands, and Gibraltar. Germany was where my sister was born, in March 2002. A few years later, while I was still in Germany, my family met this new family, the Franklin family. That was when I met Jim for the first time, born in December 2002. One memory I have of Jim when I was in Germany was when he was messing around with thorn bushes by our house. Then came my 6th birthday in 2005. This was the moment when I first started remembering everything. On my 6th birthday, I had birthday cake that said, "Happy 6th birthday," to me. And I was still in Germany. A lot has happened when I was 6 years old. On December 5th of that year, we left Germany and moved to Thousand Oaks, Texas, in the United States. We went to visit the Parker family in San Angelo for Christmas in 2005. This was my very first memory of the Parker family. I even met their two chihuahuas, Petey and Sophia. Sophia died from a snake bite in 2008, or maybe 2009, while Petey died from old age in March 2017. Anyway, in January 2006, we adopted our very first pet, a domestic short-haired cat named Bonita. She is still alive to this day. We celebrate her birthday in October because the pet shop owner told us that she was born 3 months before we adopted her. In April 2006, my family and I moved to Albuquerque, New Mexico, and moved into our house 3 days later. This all happened when I was 6 years old, and I started remembering about my age as well as how months and years worked. In fact, 2006 was the first year I could remember. We stayed in New Mexico for a little over 3 years. We also adopted our first dog, a mix between a black Labrador and a German Shepherd, and we named him Louis, after Bradley Nowell's dog. Bradley Nowell was the lead singer of this 90s ska punk band called Sublime. He died from a drug overdose in 1996. We adopted Louis in December 2006. He used to be smaller than our cat, but then he grew up so fast I could hardly believe it. Moving forward to July 2007. Before we left to visit the Parker family once again, we gave our cat Bonita 3 oversized bowls of cat food. The Parker family lived in California at the time, and I still met Petey and Sophia. When we returned home, our cat looked much bigger than before. That was a mistake we hopefully will never make again. New Mexico was where my sister and I used to play with our paternal grandfather, but he had cancer and died in the summer of 2009. Around that time, I found out that someone else had cancer. Remember when I talked about Jim from the Franklin family? Well, guess what happened? I was told that Jim was in the hospital, and that kind of shocked me, making me wonder if it was that same boy that was messing with the thorn bush in Germany. And sure enough, it was. There were just too many things that happened while I was in New Mexico, so I'm just going to move on to the summer of 2009. That was when we moved to Cocoa Beach, Florida. We were all very excited to move to Florida because of all the beaches and water parks. We liked Florida so much that we only went on one airplane trip outside of Florida, compared to at least 3 airplane rides while we were in New Mexico. But guess what that one airplane trip was about? I just mentioned that Jim was in the hospital, and sadly, he did not survive. It turns out he had some form of sarcoma, stage 4. We had to go to his funeral in Texas in November 2009. Texas was pretty much where Jim spent his entire life. He was almost 7 years old. Anyway, while we were in Florida, we adopted some fish to keep as pets. My sister's fish lived for only a year, while my fish lived for nearly 2 years. In November 2011, my father took a job in the city of Tampa, so my family would visit him often until his work ended there in May 2012. We stayed in 2 houses while we were in Florida. First we stayed in a 2-story house between 2009 and 2010. And then we moved in a 1-story house in the summer of 2010, where we stayed for 2 more years. In the summer of 2012, we moved to Hopkins, South Carolina. I didn't really like it very much, because it was incredibly hot, and hot weather would attract stinging insects like wasps. Did I mention that I had a fear of wasps? I remember this one moment when we were preparing for Halloween in 2013, when we made the mistake of placing bloody handprints on the windows by our front door. Apparently wasps are attracted to bloody handprints. Unlike New Mexico and Florida, we stayed in South Carolina for 4 years. In the summer of 2013, we went to visit the Parker family once again in Texas. And in December 2013, we flew on our first airplane in 4 years to visit my uncle in Colorado. The trip to Colorado was okay, but the trip back was a different story. There was a terrible windstorm at the airport we were landing in Atlanta, Georgia, and the pilot had to abort the landing. This caused major turbulence, and I can't say I didn't throw up during this time. Let's move on. In August 2014, the Parker family moved near Charlottesville, Virginia, which was 7 hours from where we lived, so we visited them often. On my 16th birthday in 2015, I got this YouTube channel and posted my very first video. Check out the video in the top right corner of this video screen. For the entire month of December in 2015, my family and I stayed in Perth, Australia, to visit my maternal relatives. This was my first memory of Australia, since I could not remember visiting Australia when I was just 1 year old. So then came the summer of 2016, we moved to Hanover in Maryland, north of Washington DC and south of Baltimore. We lived 3 hours from the Parker family, so we visited them even more often. We only stayed in Maryland for 2 years, as I thought we would be staying for 4. In September 2017, our dog Louis had passed away from some sort of fluid buildup in his lungs. He was almost 11 years old. We were all shocked because we thought our cat Bonita was going to die first, because she's older than Louis, and she's been having hip problems starting in 2012. In December 2017, the Parker family moved away to California, which is far from where we live. Then in the summer of 2018, we moved to O'Fallon, Illinois. This is where I live right now. Moving on to December 2018, that was when we visited the Bahamas for 1 week, and then returned in January 2019. And, just a while ago, I had graduated from an online school called Florida Virtual School, in May 2019. I was in Florida, where my graduation took place at the University of Central Florida in Orlando. I didn't think it would be such a big event for an online school. Then on July 20th, my family and I went on another vacation, this time to Hawaii, but this time, we stayed on a different island for 10 days. This was the second time I've been in Hawaii, since I was born there the first time, and this was the first time my sister went. We went to the Luau on July 23rd, and we also visited numerous beaches during our holiday, and we even visited North Shore. My parents are obsessed with beaches, we haven't lived near a beach in over a decade now, and they were pretty upset about that. We came back on July 30th, and it was around 5 in the morning when our 8-hour plane ride landed back in Chicago. And then we drove for around 3 hours back home in O'Fallon. And I just started my college class at Curtin University on August 26th. Well, I guess I'm up to date for now. Thanks for watching. You should make a video about your own life someday. I hope you enjoyed. Let me know what you thought about the topic I discussed, and don't forget to subscribe. I will see you later.